Hi everyone, my name is Anushka Jain and I work as the Associate Counsel for Transparency and Right to Information at the Internet Freedom Foundation. In this video, I'm going to talk to you about the centralized monitoring system as part of our ongoing Watch the Watchman series, in which we take a closer look at the various surveillance technology projects that the government is currently developing or has already deployed. Like NACGRID, the CMS was conceptualized after the 2611 attacks to strengthen the internal security structure of the country. The project was approved by the Cabinet Committee on Security on 16th June 2011 and the pilot project was completed by 30th September 2011. The centralized monitoring system has been set up by the Center for Development of Telematics and is operated by the Telecom Enforcement Resource and Monitoring Cells under the Department of Telecommunications. The estimated budget for the project was 400 crores. However, the actual cost of the project is said to be much higher. The project was delayed multiple times and was finally operationalized in 2013. However, the implementation is being done in phases. As you may be aware, in this series, we try to look at the privacy concerns surrounding such surveillance technology projects. However, before we get into that, I would like to talk to you about what the CMS is and what it does. The CMS is an ambitious surveillance system that monitors text messages, social media engagement, and phone calls on landlines and cell phones, among other communications. The CMS aims to automate the process of lawful interception and monitoring of telecommunications. Before CMS, law enforcement agencies had to approach individual telecom service providers, that is TSPs, for interception and communication of targets such as suspected terrorists or criminals. However, the CMS aims to remove or bypass the middleman, that is the TSPs, and allow the law enforcement agencies to monitor the target through a central system. Whereas before, the government had to request the TSPs that user information be monitored and turned over to the authorities, under CMS, the Indian government can tap into communications at will without telling the service providers. For the sake of brevity, we can summarize the salient features of CMS as follows. First, direct electronic provisioning of the target number by the government agency without any manual intervention from telephone service providers. Second, the building of central and regional databases, which will help the central and state level law enforcement agencies in interception and monitoring. Third, analysis of call data records to help establish linkage between antisocial or anti-national elements. Fourth, research and development in related fields for the continuous upgradation of the CMS. The 10 participating agencies of the CMS are the Intelligence Bureau, the Central Bureau of Investigation, the Directorate of Revenue Intelligence, the Research and Analysis Wing, the National Investigation Agency, the Narcotics Control Bureau, the Enforcement Directorate, the Central Board of Direct Taxes, the Directorate of Signal Intelligence, and the Commissioner of Police in New Delhi. Now we come to the main part of the video in which we talk about the privacy concerns surrounding CMS. In the absence of a data protection law in India and without any intermediaries like the telecom service providers in place, the process through which interception would be done under the CMS lacks transparency. What I mean by this is that the general public will not know if and when a person's data has been intercepted. It would also be difficult to ascertain whether there was a valid reason for the interception, and a practice of mass surveillance could be adopted wherein large groups of people would have their data intercepted without a valid reason. Since these interception authorizations will be done by the government agencies internally, there will be no way of knowing about them and whether they were done for a valid reason, let alone questioning or challenging them in court. The CMS reportedly has a review committee under the chairmanship of the cabinet secretary at the central government level and the chief secretary at the state government level. This fails to meet the threshold laid down in the right to privacy judgment by the Supreme Court. This is because the right to privacy judgment mandates that independent procedural safeguards be put in place to prevent abuse, which do not exist within the CMS framework. As we have pointed out previously, in our video about the NACGRID and now through the CMS, the government is putting into place a system which strongly threatens the privacy of Indian citizens. Without a data protection law in place and in the absence of a strong surveillance law framework, we could soon be living in a surveillance state. Thank you.